guide to the crypto craze here on Cheddar, brought to you, of course, by our friends over at HP. VC capital firm Perfect was founded in 2014. Future Perfect was founded in 2014 and was an early investor in blockchain and cryptocurrency startups. So joining us now is the firm's founder and managing partner, Jalak Jobanputra. Jalak, such a pleasure to have you on. Thank you.
It's great to be here.
Thank you so much. So as an early investor in this space, what is your take? I'm fascinated on not only the fact that we're getting varying offer and prices, basically, in Bitcoin this week, but also all the volatility that's happening with them.
Yeah, well, it's been a wild week in the Wild West here. What we saw at the end of last week was that Bitcoin was over 10,000. People thought it had a great run-up. But then the CME and the CBOE announced that futures trading was going to get started probably sooner than some people had expected. And that really started the run-up. And then a few days ago, we heard Goldman saying that they were going to clear some of these futures trades too. So that was another large player kind of legitimizing the market. So I think it's a lot of excitement, a lot of people who weren't believers before now thinking, wow, this may actually become an asset class.
Well, but speaking of believers, you've been a believer in this for years. What first attracted you to investing in Bitcoin back in, I believe, 2013?
2014. I went to my first Bitcoin conference in 2013. I invested in the early days of the internet, so I started my venture career in the mid-90s. And when I started my fund, I was really looking for what's really next, not just the next mobile app, but what is some paradigm-shifting technology for the future. And I was sold at that first Bitcoin conference. Kind of the energy that was there was the same energy I saw with the early internet conferences. And it was this whole idea that we can actually clear transactions, not just currency transactions, but data transactions without intermediaries. The 20th century was built on intermediaries, and I believe the 21st century is going to be dedicated to dismantling these intermediaries.
We do hear a lot of, it's so interesting that you have this background in technology and you were essentially working in venture capital during the first internet craze.
Yes.
We see a lot of people right now talking about how that these days are very similar to that. Of course, that didn't end well for a lot of people, the first dot-com bubble. Do you see this, any similarities there, or does that sort of end with sort of the bursting of that bubble?
Yeah, I think it's important to remember that while there was a bubble and a bursting of the bubble back then, the technology is ubiquitous. And the largest value, most valued companies in the world are technology companies. So just because there was a bubble and a bursting of the bubble, we had a lot of speculators, a lot of people wanting to get rich quick there, the technology stayed around. And I believe that's going to happen with this. There's no going back on blockchain technology and the underlying technology behind cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin. We have had a huge run-up and number of ICOs that have launched initial coin offerings. I think 90%+ of those are not going to be around in a year or two. And so that's where I see some similarities. But in terms of the underlying technology, that's not going away.
Let's talk about some of the stuff that's in your portfolio right now. What's interesting you?
Well, I have lots of great companies in the portfolio. So the way I looked at investing in the space from the venture capital perspective.
And those are some of the ones that you have in your portfolio right now as well.
So these are companies that are building out the underlying infrastructure and also benefiting from the price rise of Bitcoin. So it's the infrastructure plus the cryptocurrency. We have a company called BitPesa that's the Bitcoin platform for Africa. It can cost up to 20% of a transaction to transfer money from one African country to another. By doing this on the Bitcoin blockchain as a back end and not touching the banks, they've actually brought that fee down to less than 3%.
Are you also interested in companies that don't necessarily work with Bitcoin or cryptocurrency, but just focus on the underlying blockchain technology? And if yes, can you just explain how those companies utilize blockchain? Because I think a lot of the discussion around blockchain really focuses on cryptocurrencies and people don't realize it can be used for so much more.
Absolutely, and I view cryptocurrency as a small subset of blockchain technology. So it's just a couple percentage points of what the technology is capable of. I have a company called Everledger in the portfolio, and they have addressed the diamond market. There's a lot of counterfeiting and fraud in the diamond industry, fraud even when you have GIA certificates. People can cut diamonds and then transfer them over. So what they've done is bring diamonds onto the blockchain. So you can track a diamond from mine all the way to retail, purchase and issue blockchain-based certificates. And they've actually partnered with the Singapore Diamond Exchange. So traders can feel comfortable that the asset that they're trading has is that underlying asset, physical asset. And they also partner with GIA.
And I want, you mentioned technology. I want to see where your position on where you feel like the technological opportunities are moving forward with this.
Well, just like 1994 internet, when we didn't realize we'd be watching Cheddar online,
right,
or actually transacting through wallets, digital wallets. I think we don't know exactly what all the business models are going to be. I do think a lot of them are going to come outside of developed markets, which is why our portfolio crosses the developed as well as developing markets, because a lot of these countries in Africa, India, Latin America don't have financial institutions, they don't have insurance, they don't have kind of the media industry that we do. So if you start to think of starting from scratch and being able to build all assets on the blockchain and being able to kind of securitize them on the blockchain, it gets really exciting.
Very, very, very exciting. We love that you came over and talked to us about all this. That's Jalak Jobanputra. She's the founder and managing partner of Future Perfect Venture Partners. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Of course. And remember, guys, to tune into our special half-hour crypto show again next Friday. We can't wait to do this every Friday, it seems like. 3 p.m., the Crypto Craze.